You know, well, this evening, we know it's a tough time for the community, for the Jewish community. We're here just to let all the Jewish families know that we are praying, and we are mourning with all the families and the community. And as we're here representing the clergy and the Caribbean community, you know, we want to let all the families know today that we are here. And you know, God, you know, bless all, you know, the Jewish families, and we continue to pray, you know, that God will heal all the families and keep us as we go ahead. And that's why we're here tonight, just to, you know, show our condolences to the family. We're here to give our support and our prayers for this community. I know it's a tough time for the city and for our nation today. Well, when I heard that the young man was missing, you know, we too, you know, were volunteering, and you know, we were out there calling our congregation, we were calling our parishioners, our members in our churches, and we were telling them to make sure that, you know, if they see this young man, that they should call the police. And you know, when we heard that, you know, the young man was found, we were happy. But again, when we heard that he passed away, we all begin to mourn, and it's a grieving and touching, and it's a sad thing that ever happened to any human being, you know, that living in this world. So we want to let the community know, all our rabbis and our clergy know that we are in prayers, and we are continue to pray for this community and to pray for the Jewish families, because, you know, it's gonna take some time to be healed. And we are grieving together, and we are mourning together, and we are praying together. And God bless you. And God bless America, and God bless Israel and Jerusalem. Shalom, Adonai, Elohim. God bless you.
My name is Jennifer, and my heart was broken when I heard it, and I could just barely imagine what the parents went through. I was just so broken, heartbroken about the whole event. It's very sad, very, very sad.
If you could say something to the parents, like what would you say to them?
My heart is with you. I've been praying for you ever since I heard the disappearance of your son. And I'm continue to pray that the healing balm of Gilead just come and God just minister to your heart and mend that brokenness that you are experiencing.
Yeah, I'm really, really upset. How could you kill a child like that and put his body in the freezer? This is ridiculous. Why would he do that? I can't get it. Is he crazy or what?
They have said that he does need help. Like, you know, he needs psychiatric attention and things of that nature.
He needs no psychiatric treatment. I think he's planning that because he knows he get left. He's not mad. He's not crazy. And trying to do things, that's what they said and what they do, just to say they're mad and they're crazy to get away. Nothing like that. He's not crazy. And this man looks like he do it more than one time.
What are your feelings towards the incident that has occurred?
I cannot believe that somebody would actually do that to a child.